warm evening, isn't it? I'm glad to be here to share my views on cybersecurity. And let me start with a quick question. How many of you are concerned about your privacy? And for sure, after a few minutes of time, you will know where you stand. Because my talk will be all with the cybersecurity things and what we have done so far and what can be done to ensure that you are safe in the digital world. We all had this experience. When you plan to buy a jacket, imagine this. When you plan to buy a jacket and you discuss this with your friend, and after a few minutes of time, an ad showing the same jacket popping up on your phone. Can you all relate this one? These are the small ripple effects that we have created just because of our digital actions. It's not a magic, and of course, it is not a coincidence either. These are very common among us, but we barely notice it. Myself, Manimuthu, professor of cybersecurity, who works on blockchain, artificial intelligence, and cybersecurity. Think about it. When you sign up for a new app or services, probably it will be asking for an email ID. And of course, following that, it is going to ask for a password. And I agree with all of these things, right? Everybody goes with the same password and the same email ID. Who has time for all the email IDs to remember, and who has all the time for remember the passwords as well? And of course, I am one of you as well. Over 65% of us reuse the same password across multiple platforms. But the problem here is, what if any one of those accounts gets compromised? All your accounts linked with that particular email ID will become vulnerable. Though it seems to be like a small action, it is definitely going to have huge consequences, and it can turn up against us as well. And the next common problem here is, how many times have you clicked "I agree" on terms and conditions blindly? We have done all this time forever, and who has time for all these things, isn't it? We never go with the terms and conditions anytime. But what if I say, if any of those terms and conditions allowed us access to your microphone, camera, or locations? And you know what? Most of the popular apps have exploited this opportunity. Yeah? A study clearly shows this. And it is that you are essentially giving a stranger a key to your privacy. That's the ripple effect that we have created, not only because of your digital awareness, but also because of your digital negligence. The third thing is, the most commonality among us is, like, when you post a vacation photo, probably you are unintentionally signaling a third person that your house is empty. And it seems harmless actions, but burglars in the digital age have exploited this option as well. And a study clearly shows 78% of the burglars admit this. They use social media as one of the platforms to find their potential targets. And now let's talk about the silent data collectors, the smart devices around us, starting from your smartphones, smart watches, and smart devices in and around your home. And you know what? Whether you are using those devices or not, those devices definitely going to collect some sort of data from you. And a study clearly shows that over 50% of the people don't even realize that these devices are actually collecting the data. And you aren't not connected with the internet alone. You are being watched by it. These small silent ripples of data collections can eventually turn into waves, and it can be your personal information, or it can be and information about your family, or it can be of anything else which can be possibly misused by the third parties. Let's bring it back to something. We all within this digital environment, what we can control for, what we can do now. Even though these data ripples may feel overwhelming, there are simple and practical steps that you can try from now onwards. The first thing, check on the apps, see what are the things you have given permission for. Whether it is for location, whether it is for your health conditions, whether it is for your whatever the habitual things you are just putting up for, everything. Another easy win is try to adjust your privacy. Go with the privacy settings. It doesn't take much time. See what the privacy settings offers for you. And if it is not needed actually for the app to perform it, turn it off. It's as simple as it is. And lastly, keep the softwares updated. And I know we will definitely get bored of this one, and we never have time for this one as well, like our old-fashioned operating systems. But these softwares helps us to fix bugs where it can be a potential opportunities for hackers to get into our systems. These small actions, can prevent data ripples. They're definitely going to be turning out into a waves for sure. And yes, we have talked a lot of small actions today. And my opinion and my experience says is, be mindful of what you share, where you share, when you share, and how you share. Because I don't want my vacation to end up in a tragedy by signaling an intruder into my home. And just in case, if you are really interested to navigate your privacy, you have to be very proactive. You have to be very realistic. Just in case, if you are not doing all those things, you will never care for your privacy nightmare. And this is something we have to navigate with caution as well as precaution. And for sure, you all agree with this thing. The apps on your mobile phone definitely knows more about you than your wife or husband. I'm not talking about the browsing history alone. It's your health conditions, exercise patterns, sleep patterns, even calendars, everything. Yeah? We have already created a digital replica of ourselves. We have fed enough information to it. We already have a digital twin of ourselves. The apps on your mobile phone definitely going to collect your location, whether it is in your pocket or whether you are using it or not. For sure, we have to be very cautious and we have to act precautiously just in case if you want to navigate any of these things immediately. And I just leave this thing to you people. Your privacy supposed to be and definitely has to be on your control. And yes, our digital life really matters. Thank you so much.